The dreaded border crossing into Nicaragua was not too bad and took about 2 hours. It was here where I crossed over from the Caribbean side to the Pacific. It is very dry and hot, even thorn bushes, and the heat is stifling. Even after sunset, there's almost no relief. I've resorted to leaving early in the mornings, way before sunrise, to avoid the suppressing heat. One of my highlights was a night tour to the Masaya volcano, one of the world's most active volcanoes and one of the few places where you can see the active lava lake. The following day, onwards to Lake Nicaragua. It is the only freshwater lake to have ocean animals, including sharks and swordfish. It is believed the lake was once an ocean bay, but then a volcano erupted, trapping marine life and turning it into an inland lake. Over the millennia, the marine life has adapted to living in the fresh water.
Come this one. I'll go there. You spot. Costa Rica, the land of sloths, crocodiles, toucans, macaws and numerous other parrot species, and of course the howler monkey. I was warned, Costa Rica is very expensive. At least here I was able to leave the busy Trans-Am highway and cycle more of the remote coastal areas. The roads on my route were 90% unpaved. Some river crossings are too deep to cycle, so I have to remove the panniers and carry everything to the far bank. Even more fun knowing that there are crocodiles lurking in these waters. Some of the climbs are brutal, forcing me to dismount and push.
In the next clip, you will be able to hear the howler monkeys in the background. Don't always trust the maps. My route led me into a private property and a stone quarry. I was fortunate to be escorted through the quarry and onto a road where I could continue. The bridge into Panama City. This was hectic as there was no shoulder. To make matters worse, I punctured on the crest of the bridge. The question that I get asked the most, where are you heading? Followed by, how old are you? Panama is not much fun for cycle touring. There are no scenic coastal roads to follow. So it was pretty much just a slog along the Transam to get to Panama City. The Transam was meant to go through to Colombia, but was never completed. A small 100 kilometer strip of marshland and mountains separates Panama from Colombia, called the Darien Gap.